And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, Kirby's Dream Land for the Nintendo Game Boy, 1992. Guys, you have no idea. I played this game. This was my first Game Boy game when I was a kid. My mom got it for me for Christmas. You know, she put it in a clothes box. You know, like, oh, I got clothes for Christmas. Damn it. Why do I have to get clothes for Christmas? But no. Opened the box. It was Kirby and some other game. I don't even remember what it was. Now, Kirby's Dream Land for Game Boy, I know people like to say it's really simple, and it is, but this game, and I would argue the NES game, are probably the only Kirby games I've probably ever died in. Now, as a kid, I died at this game a lot, because I guess when you're younger, and this game is marketed toward younger players, but it is for everyone. As I've argued in the video, Kirby for Kids, no way! I've played Kirby games like Kirby's Epic Yarn was easy, yet it was very fun, and you can make it difficult too. This game, it has that classic feel, it's very straightforward. As you see, I'm just sucking up these enemies, spitting them out, and we're just gonna keep going and doing this, because, I don't know, and I like to focus on the score. See, back then, back in the day, years ago, in a time where most of you may not remember, we used to keep score in video games, and I like to focus on the score, so, I mean, you see me killing a lot of these enemies, because I'm like, gotta rack up this score, but you know, you're not really getting much points from these enemies. You get more points from bosses. Some enemies will give you 1,000 points. Now, this is a classic Kirby boss character, and all you're gonna need to do is suck up these apples, spit them right back out. Now, when you beat this game, there's a special version of this Kirby game, and that version is way tougher than this version. I wouldn't even really say this game is tough. You may die once or twice if you become careless, maybe at the boss fights, but the special game, the second mission, I like to call it, it's much harder than this. I want to say much harder, it's not too much harder. It's just one of those things, I don't know, you just can't... You couldn't really rush through it like this. Now, this Kirby game has a lot of classic tunes to it. I don't know, it's probably one of my favorites. Kirby's Epic Yarn had some great music, and I think that's because of the piano. I really like the piano solos in Kirby's Epic Yarn, and this is really just classic Kirby. I like to think of this game as, you know, Nintendo wanted to make a new franchise, a new game, and they just had this idea and just ran with it. So a lot of people say, oh, but Kirby can't copy abilities and stuff. Well, this was like his first game. They were trying to figure out what they can use Kirby for, do with Kirby. They probably had an idea, you know, we should have a character where we just have them suck up bad guys, spit them out at other bad guys. That's probably the only thing they were thinking. And you have to keep it simple for the Game Boy. You can't really do that much on the Game Boy. When it comes to graphics, when it comes to stages, and how in-depth the game could be. For example, this game only has 5 stages. So it's a really quick playthrough. You could probably beat it under a half hour. Maybe even shorter if you're trying to speedrun it. But Kirby doesn't really move that fast, and the only time he really does is when you get the Starman type power-up. I see Kirby's going crazy here with this power-up. Moving a little faster. A little crazier, I guess. I guess he just ate some hot stuff. I mean, it's pretty much how I feel when I put too much hot sauce in food. You know, from that Cholula, that Tapatio. Just burns. But Kirby, he's one of those Nintendo characters you either love or you just don't care for. I know it's either... I would say he's a love or hate, but I think most people love Kirby. So here's a low, and la, I believe. And this is a really straightforward fight. They're just pushing boxes. They're probably just... This is their storage room. They're, you know, moving some furniture. They're moving pots and pans. Like, oh, we just moved in our castle, and Kirby's here. Just... abusing us. Like, we're not doing anything. They're not even trying to attack him. But I just killed them. Whatever. I guess the castle's mine now. And in classic Kirby fashion, we must dance to our win. So here we are, stage 3, Float Islands. This was my least favorite stage. I don't know what it is about this stage I don't like. I guess it's summery. Very tropical, I guess. I don't know. I think it's the music, actually. I'm not really fond of this track, but these kind of stages, I'm not really a fan of, where it's just summery and there's crabs. It's very, it's kind of cliche. I would argue, but that's okay. I mean, again, this is just a Kirby game. While we're being, you know, judgmental on it, I don't know. I'm being judgmental, not we. I don't know why I'm saying we. I'm sure you guys can defend the stage. Oh, actually, in the comments, let me know what your favorite stage in this game is. I would argue mine is the next one. And it's all in the sky. And the music in this next stage is pretty good, too. And yes, Kirby, it's just... Yeah, I'm just trying to really pinpoint exactly where I don't like this stage. I don't know, I think it's just boring, to be honest. It's like, not much is going on. Remember in the first stage where I was just running through, killing bad guys? It's just, this one I'm just... Oh, here we go, one up, just... And oh, here's some bad guys, and you know, it's... I don't know, it's... It's not that great. I don't know. They did somewhat remake this game in Kirby Superstar. There are some differences, and I really enjoyed that, seeing this game with updated graphics and color. Now, I did play this game on Game Boy Color, I think, too, but, you know, Game Boy Color had that fake color. It was almost like, you know how they have It's a Wonderful Life, that movie, that Christmas movie, and they put it in that fake color. There is a color version out there, but it's almost like they painted over the film stock to make it look like it's in color. So it almost looks real, but it's not. That's how like Game Boy Color was to me. It was like, oh, it's in color, but they always had random colors for everything. And just looking at this game, playing it right now in some black and white, I'm like thinking, man, what's this gonna be like in 100 years? I guess from 92 and then, let's see, 2092. Like, what are people gonna be thinking of Game Boy games, NES games? All the games that I grew up with, that you guys grew up with, how are we gonna look at them? Because the other day, I was watching The Day the Earth Stood Still, the original one, and I would hear people say stuff like, man, this is really old, or, oh, this is an old movie, and people wouldn't want to watch it. And where I was watching it was in a store. You know, I only watched it for a little bit, but people would pass by and they were saying stuff like, wow, this is one of those old movies. This is one of those old sci-fi movies, and look how boring it looks, or look how fake it looks, or, I don't know, stuff like that. And I look at this, and I ask, are people gonna think, now here's my favorite stage, Bubbly Clouds, now, are people gonna think the same thing, or they'll, in 100 years, I guess from 92, so in like 2092, are they gonna look at Kirby's Dream Land as, wow, look at this game, it's black and white, and it's not even in HD, and unless I guess they update it. I don't know if they're Nintendo's gonna update any of these games in HD or anything, but let's say they don't. These are just gonna be artifacts of a simpler time. You know, Kirby's Dream Land, Super Mario Brothers, where they'll be looked at as those old games, the classic games. I mean, if you look at any of the Oscar winners from the past, I mean, do you think people will go out of their way to see those movies just because they were once loved by people? Or will people just look at them and like, oh, well, that was history of film, or that's history of video games, and those games don't hold up like they do today. It might be different for video games and movies. I don't know, because video games are an interactive experience. Like Kirby, I can play this game over and over again. And I think that goes with Mario Brothers, and that's why Super Mario Brothers, that holds a special thing in everyone's hearts, because, I mean, there was a time when Nintendo and video games was synonymous, where your parents wouldn't say, oh, go play your games, or, you know, go put your games away. It's, go play Nintendo, go put your Nintendo away. And even Game Boy, too, is so popular, where that's all parents kind of knew. They knew Nintendo, they knew that brand. Nowadays, it's PlayStation. I've heard parents mention PlayStation, and it's just weird to me. The times change, and some parents still call Nintendo Nintendo, and like, it's if you're playing Xbox, and I don't know if your parents would ever say, oh, put away your Nintendo. Like, probably not. It's possible. But I remember growing up where parents would just say, put away your Nintendo, and like, my friend had a Genesis. So, it just, Nintendo was that popular back in the day. But playing Kirby, like this game, because I remember playing this as a kid. I remember playing on my Game Boy, sitting on the couch, and I would sit under a lamp, because you know how Game Boy, you cannot see the screen without having good lighting. I would sit under this lamp, like right under it, where the screen would look perfect, and I just remember sitting there playing that game. I had headphones on, and playing Kirby's Dream Land on the Game Boy. You know, I was just a kid, got it for Christmas. It was good times, and I know a lot of people like to attach nostalgia to games and stuff, and I definitely do. That's why I picked up this Kirby's Dream Collection. Now, I have not played all of the games on this Kirby's Dream Collection. When I picked this up, you know, the reason why I bought this is because I haven't played all the Kirby games. I played Epic Yarn, I played this one, I played the NES Kirby's Adventure, but the other ones I have not played yet. I have not played Kirby's Dream Land 2. I have not played Kirby 64, and that's crazy because N64 was one of my favorite consoles, and is one of my favorite consoles to this day. Yeah, I never played Kirby 64, and I guess that's because it came out around the year 2000, and around that time, I was like, what was I playing? Perfect Dark and Conker's Bad Fur Day. And I don't think it really got my attention, because I remember seeing it in magazines and thinking, that doesn't look like Kirby. I don't know, maybe to me it just didn't seem like Kirby was really transferred well to 64. Again, I've not played it, so I can't say that yet, but I remember when it came out, I was thinking, that doesn't look like a Kirby game. But that doesn't look like... Okay, this... Now this boss... is messing me up. Now, the thing is to stay in the corner, because he can't hit you when you're in the corner. I'm getting all nervous, because I can't... Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that may be the first time in history that anyone's ever died in a Kirby game. Okay, well, that's fine. I'm not embarrassed by that. So, let's beat him this time. And, oh gosh, see, if I do bad now, it's not gonna really show how much I've played this this game. Stay in the corner, don't let him hit you. When he releases an enemy, just let the enemy walk towards you, and then grab it. See, I'm afraid if I go get it now, he's gonna come and die. So, yeah, see, he dove down, and I would've got- oh, I got hit anyways. So my advice for this boss is just to keep your distance. If you actually need any advice for this boss. But anyways, just go back to all the stuff I was saying. Kirby 64, again, I just wasn't interested at the time. But it's funny, because now, years later, almost a decade later, I guess. No, oh my god, it's been way more than that. It's like, I'm losing track of time. It's 2012 now. And Kirby 64, 12 years ago already. I'm, like, interested in playing it for some reason. I'm like, wow, like, I missed out playing this game. I really want to check it out. So, this is why Kirby's Dream Collection is great, because it's for people that have not played any of the Kirby games. Or maybe some of the Kirby games, and that's me. It's for people who maybe have played them in the past. And, you know, got rid of them, they sold them to GameStop, whatever. They just don't have them anymore. I'm like, oh, nostalgia. I want to play those games again. And of course, the new generation that's never played any Kirby games, and maybe they only know Kirby from Smash Brothers, maybe they only played Epic Yarn, maybe they've only played the newer Kirby games, and, you know, it's nice to release something like this to show Kirby's roots, where he came from. Stuff like this is great, I've always thought, and I love the stuff that was that Sony's doing and Xbox, where they're re-releasing stuff on in their stores, like HD collections of certain games. I really like that, because it's just to give this newer generation of gamers history, in a way. And at least update it a little bit in HD, so you can at least enjoy it with a little better graphics than you remember. So I hope Nintendo does that for Wii U, where they re-release games in HD. I don't know if re-releasing Mario Brothers for the billionth time in HD would matter, but, you know, I didn't pick up that Mario Brothers anniversary set because it was just Super Mario All-Stars repackaged, and I played Super Mario All-Stars to death. Now, this section of the game is like Mega Man, where you're at the boss, or you think you're at the boss, because we're at Mount DDD, and you have to refight all the bosses. Now, luckily, that last Cloud boss, I did not die, like last time. And here we go, killing Lolo and La 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 again, because they had one more chance to redeem themselves. They just want to move their stuff. And they're different departments, their house, but Kirby's like, no, it's not gonna happen. So in this section, it's like Mega Man, where you have to refight all the bosses, and I would guess, if I was a video game developer, this is just to make the game longer and a little more challenging, like, oh, and also almost like a little thing where it makes you remember, like, oh yeah, these bosses, I gotta fight them again. Because I remember in a Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, a complaint people had when the game first came out was that you couldn't go back and refight the bosses. I mean, why? Because the bosses were awesome, and we couldn't even go back and relive that, so that's why Nintendo did that in Majora's Mask, where you were able to go back and fight the bosses again, and then they did it in Wind Waker, where you can go back and fight the bosses, but when you did, I remember it was in Ganon's Castle, where everything was in black and white, which I thought was pretty cool in Wind Waker. But yeah, Kirby did that. Kirby stole that idea. But I think, again, it's just to make the game a little longer, and it's just using the same graphics and everything, so I'm sure it doesn't really take up much space. Same thing, that's why in Mortal Kombat they used Sub-Zero and Scorpion, you know, same graphics, but different colors. Like, Sub-Zero's blue, Scorpion's yellow, it's pretty much the same character. And the sprites are tweaked just a tad, and you got two different characters that way. Probably doesn't take that much memory, but, you know, if you guys know the specifics of it, you can always let me know in the comments, but that's what I'm only thinking. I'm not a video game creator. I play them. I don't make them. One day I would love to make video games, though, as a producer. I couldn't do the math or know the math to actually make video games and sit there on a computer and do what you have to do in that sense. Those guys who do this stuff are very talented. Now here we are, King DDD. Now, King DDD got really popular from Smash Brothers, thanks to Smash Brothers Brawl. This boss music is great. I remember totally loving this as a kid, and it still holds up, even today. It's pretty good boss music. It's very memorable. It's a very memorable tune. But his pattern is pretty simple in this sense. Like, the special version of this Kirby game, after you beat it, or if you put in the code in the beginning of the game, he's much harder. But here, he runs towards you, dives, then he'll whip out his hammer, and then he does just back away, get the stars, shoot it back. Oh, I missed it there. And sometimes he tries to pull a Kirby and suck you up and spit you out, but we're not gonna let that happen. And here, oh, that was a double hit, so that's good. So just keep your distance. Oh, see, I almost got killed there. Oh, okay. One more time, and he's done. He's done. He is done. Okay. And we end the game at 331,000 points, which I don't know if I could do better. See, enemies could respawn in this game, and you can probably kill them over and over again to rack up your points. It would be a challenge for me to get 1,000,000 points. I'm gonna have to try that sometime. And here we go, Kirby has earned his power. And I guess he is giving food back to everybody. I don't remember the story to this game, actually. I guess King DDD stole all the food in the land. I'm pretty sure that's what the storyline was. So Kirby is just releasing all the food back to the world. which is good, because, you know, we need that food. And he is the king of Dreamland. Kirby's Dreamland, yes. And there you have it, folks. That's Kirby's Dreamland for the Game Boy. Notice the credits here. It doesn't really last too long. It's only a handful of people made this game. That was maybe like 5-6 people. You got a supervisor, producer, and as I was saying, yeah, I would love to be a video game producer, just to be behind the scenes, making sure everyone's working in order, and helping each other out. That's one of my goals in life, because I'm working towards the movie thing, being a writer, director, producer in the movie business, but being able to produce video games too would be totally a life dream for me. And I will be working towards that for sure. And there's Kirby saying bye bye. You notice in the crowd there's other Kirbys. I guess they're his family, possibly. Brothers, sisters, grandma, grandpa. His drunk uncle, you know. And here you go, extra game. Hold up, select, and A at the start screen, and that does work. So when you do that, you get a harder version, a more difficult version of this game. There you have it, folks, Kirby's Dream Land. Now, on the right, you can leave and go back to the classic titles page, Kirby's History, Challenge Stages. Please subscribe, like us on Facebook, do all that great stuff, and if you don't like any of this stuff, or if you don't do any of that, I'm sure the playlist will just take you to the next game.